I'm David DiCerto with my Real Faith 60-plus second review of Justice League, which brings together some of DC Comics' greatest heroes. With the world still mourning the death of Henry Cavill's Man of Steel and the hope he inspired, it's up to Ben Affleck's Batman and Gal Gadot's Wonder Woman to lead new recruits, Jason Momoa's Aquaman, Ezra Miller's Flash, and Ray Fisher's Cyborg, to save the planet from another generic interdimensional villain. While not in the same league as this summer's aspirational Wonder Woman, it does strive to introduce some levity into what so far has been the DC Cinematic Universe's kryptonite, its dark and humorless tone. It also moves towards making Superman, whose death is short-lived, into the beacon of hope the franchise keeps teasing, though on that count, there's still a way to go. But not even Superman can leap over some of this film's hurdles, including an at times incoherent script, underdeveloped characters, and bloated action sequences. The few interesting moral questions raised, not to mention incongruent religious realities presented, get buried in the sensory overload rubble. Still, it has its moments of fanboy fun, even if the muddled whole is less than the sum of its entertaining parts. Joss Whedon, who gets a screenwriting credit and directs extensive reshoots, makes his presence felt with the witty Avenger-style banter among teammates. But those exchanges feel cut from a different cloth than director Zack Snyder's more grim, mythic aesthetic. It's as if the franchise is still trying to find the right balance of two visions. But here, it does neither justice.